sudah jelaskan. Problem with dengan owner of a business, dia tidak jelaskan area of playground. This is your playground. You can play anywhere around here, adjust anything. This is your authority, but that's your limit. And these are the things that you're allowed to play around in the playground. Kita punya malas nak clearkan playground itu, nak jelaskan playground itu. Kita kata kat dia, jangan buat lain daripada SOP ini je. 1, 2, 5, that's all your job. Don't think, don't do anything. Be stupid, just entertain the client. It doesn't motivate them. Zaman sekarang punya manusia berbeza dengan zaman ibu yang sangat compliance. Kami bodoh-bodoh ikut, even tak tanya sebab apa. Zaman sekarang punya generation, they want to know why. Yeah? They want to know why. They want to see impact. So they very much about autonomy, kebebasan untuk melakukan sesuatu mengikut hak-hak yang telah ditetapkan. So menentukan hak and ratio is extremely important in order to achieve breakthrough success. You kena ikut motivation ni dulu. Sebab tajuk kita achieving breakthrough success kan. So ibu mulakan dengan benda ni. Kejap lagi it's going to be very technical. Yang ni sekejap je ibu nak buat tentang motivasi ni. Just the opening aja. Okay, the three thing. And kedua, mastery. Dia nak ada the sense of accomplishment. Dia nak buat sesuatu capai belajar. Buat sesuatu capai belajar. Dia rasa macam, achievement. I tak pernah buat P&L closing atau buat balance sheet sampai balance. All good achievement. I tak pernah boleh layan customer sampai dia beli sekali 3 jubah. Achievement. I don't know what I did. I layan dia sampai dia beli 3 jubah. Contohnya. That is mastery. So, mastery is having superiority or control over something that can be a springboard to an experience. So, dia belajar OJT, on job training. So, dia achieve satu. So, yang bagi peluang tu siapa? Owner. Chef for example kat my story. Kalau dia masak kat belakang, I dapat compliment from the client. Call the chef out. Meet the client. Oh, you want to say something nice? Let me call the chef. They want to say something to ibu. Oh, your food was repeat lah balik. Macam kat owner tu kan. So, a sense of accomplishment is part of motivation zaman baru. And that creates mastery. Dia tahu, oh, this is what I did right. Hari tu kita buat revision, kita belajar pasal I wish I like. This is part of also the mastery journey. That means kita membenarkan staff kita buat satu kolom kat sini. Line tengah. Tajuk dia, I wish I like. Ambil post-it note? Tak. Dia tak kata keburukan satu organisasi. Dia cuma kata, I wish we could. Dia terus ke solusi. Dia tak kata, saya tak suka cara kita datang pukul 8. Tak. Dia cakap kata, I wish we could have flexi hours. Dia terus bagi solution kepada masalah yang ada. Nobody focus on problem. Everybody focus on, I like pula, dia cerita, yang kita dah buat selama ni, benda tu I suka. Jadi kita tahu apa benda kita nak maintain. Jangan terlalu kutuk sahaja, puji penting juga sebab kita nak tahu what did we do right in order for us to maintain. Kita perlu kekalkan. Nanti kita selalu fokus pada benda negatif macam jalan sengit ke apa. Kita selalu fokus pada nak buat improvement. Kita forgot how to strengthen our strengths. Okay, so I wish I like is another technique kita belajar. And then purpose. The action of result motivation. Okay, purpose ni kadang-kadang ibu tanya juga macam contoh-contohnya lah. Siapa company ni nak bagi contoh. Adalah satu produk ni katanya. Apa-apalah. Ah, Revilia. Ambil kau jadi mangsa. Mana dia? Mana kau okay? Mana kau okay, Revilia? Dah lari? Dia tahu ibu nak sebut. Okay. Give me in 5 minutes the objective Revilia, the why Revilia, the how Revilia, the what Revilia. Can you tell me? If you as a boss, you cannot explain that Diana, apakah why, big why Diana? What is your main objective? What is your purpose? Contohnya, the purpose of Diana. If you can answer that very fast, I'm quite sure everybody in Diana can answer that fast too. Even tukang sapu. You know? So the new motivation is also understanding the purpose. Kalau boss tak faham purpose, jangan nak buat nak faham purpose. Kan TRS marketing? Cuci dekat ibu dalam 5 saat aja. Apa purpose TRS marketing? Tanya bos. Okay, katalah that doesn't happen. Ibu test saja. Okay, So in a lot of way, we need to have that purpose, elevator pitch to happen. So tiga perkara ni is just an opening to achieving breakthrough success. Kita kena buat cara ini. So kalau nak, what do you call it? Tengok link yang ibu bagi dekat WhatsApp group. Is everybody in the WhatsApp group? Ada satu link tu, dia punya TED Talk tentang ni, Daniel ni. You just study that one, dia dah highlight everything important from the book. Are we good?